Hello and welcome to Time for Reflections. I wonder if you remember the song "I Don't Know How to Love Him" from the 1970 musical Jesus Christ Superstar, written by Andrew Lloyd Webber and Tim Rice. In the song, Mary Magdalene is asking about loving Jesus, and she says, "I don't know how to love him." This set me thinking, what is love anyway? Over the years, love has been interpreted into the most common denominator. People equate love with romance, sex, self-gratification, enjoyment, and so on. But there is more to love than that, surely. Love means caring, whether it is in a relationship where one genuinely cares for one's spouse and their well-being, or whether it is parental love and caring towards one's offspring, or siblings caring for each other, brothers and sisters, or indeed caring for one's neighbors, as Jesus commanded when he said, "A new commandment I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you also must love one another." You can read this in the Gospel of John, chapter 13, verse 34. So, there is more to caring than just being concerned about something or about someone. True love, true caring is different. When we become aware that someone is in difficulty and in a particular need, it is not enough to care about them and pray for them. We should get up and do something about it, physically help in any way we can, whether it's a relative or a friend or even a stranger we have heard about or read about in the news. Caring by itself is not enough. Caring must always be accompanied by action on our part. Positive action towards those in need. So let us return to the song. How do we actually love Jesus? He does not need our caring or our physical help in any way. He is God after all. So, how do we love him? Well, let's look at his example. How did Jesus love us? He could have come to earth as a divine king and ruler of all, which he is, of course, but he didn't. He came as a humble, vulnerable baby, and as he grew up, his mission on earth was to serve us. All the way to the cross, he came to serve, not to be served. Do you recall the story when he washed his disciples' feet? You can read about it in the Gospel of John, chapter 13. At the time of Jesus, things were different. streets were not as modern and clean as they are now in our towns and cities. They were dusty, muddy if it rained, and no doubt full of deposits from horses, camels, and cattle. People wore sandals or even walked in bare feet. So when people entered the house as guests, washing their feet must have been an essential task, a necessity. And the host had servants ready to wash the guests' feet as they arrived. That is the lesson Jesus was teaching us and teaching his disciples when he washed their feet. He came to serve us, not to be served. And we should do the same. If we are to love Jesus, we should do so by serving him. And the best way to do so is by loving one another as he commanded, by serving one another. Loving Jesus is to be like Jesus. To let Jesus reflect in our lives and the way we live. To be Jesus to someone every day. Love one another as I have loved you. Serve one another as I have served you. Thank you for listening. God bless.
Thank you very much for listening to Time for Reflection. This is Vic Milbrook saying bye-bye for now, and God bless.